Hi, my name is Helle Trevino. I'm an IFBB Pro. I just won the Rising Phoenix World Championship title last night. So I'm super excited to be here and have the opportunity to film with Maximum Muscle Report. Thank you very much for that. It's gonna be super fun. I'm gonna show you guys some really cool exercises. So let's start with some shoulders. I wanna show you some different variations, how you can give your shoulder workout a little bit more flair and a little bit more fun and a little bit more zinc to it. So usually I start warming up with a light weight, just doing some lateral raises, just get some blood in there. And then when I'm ready for my set, I'll do usually two, three warm-up sets till I feel like, okay, I'm nice and warm. And then I'll go to some heavier stuff, and I like to do partials a lot, so I will not go all the way to parallel like usually. So I'll just go out to about here and I'll hold it and I'll go back down. That allows me to work a lot the cap of the shoulder, and I'm gonna be able to handle a lot more weight than if I had to take it all the way up to parallel. So I like to do a lot of supersets, so I might do 10 reps here, set the weights back, take a lighter weight, and then I'm gonna do the full range of motion all the way to parallel. And notice how I'm not just dropping the weight. You want to work the positive, stop it, and you want to work against gravity when you go down. Sometimes I'll do them super, super slow, and then maybe at the end, I'll do what I call a burnout, and I'll be just go fast. I don't go all the way down. Also, you see that I'm kind of keeping the tension on the shoulder. I'm not going to relax here, so I'm doing a burnout right here, right at the end. And that's the set. And if your shoulders aren't fried after that, I don't know. The next exercise I'll do is a wide upright row. And why wide? Because it's gonna hit your shoulder caps more. So if you lift more in here, you're gonna lift more with your traps. So with this one, I try to kind of roll my shoulders back, keep the scapula, your traps down, to not engage your traps. I just want to hit the side of the shoulder, those side muscles out there. So I go in a wide position, and I don't go so high. I don't go all the way up here because that's gonna involve the traps. So shoulder blades down, and then go wide. You can either do it with a dumbbell like this, or you can grab a barbell and just get a wide grip. I kind of like the dumbbell because there's more motion in it. You know, you see how I'm putting the dumbbells together at the bottom, so it's kind of like a little half circle, and I kind of push the elbows up to really, it's almost like a side lateral, you know, where they're just the arms are hanging down. So I'm not really engaging my forearms by pulling this up. I'm just letting them hang there and just getting the shoulders as high as I can without raising the traps. And it'll give you a really good burn. I'm already feeling the burn. Delts, I like to also do supersets. So it's rare that I will just do one exercise. So I'll show you guys how you can actually combine different exercises in one set, and it will give you a really good bang. So here we are starting with a rear delt lateral raise. and I'm keeping my chest down. Like if you go up like that, you would engage more your back. So I'm staying heavy on the bench with the chest. And then I'll turn the dumbbells and I'll go this way. Key is to keep the elbows out. As soon as you're gonna put the elbows back like this, it's gonna be a row and you're gonna work your back. So you wanna keep your elbows nice and wide, pointing to the sides. And the last one could be like, I call it a skiing exercise, where you kind of push it back like this and you flex your rear delts. So I kind of make a little pause at the top, like a second. Second squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And be careful of not doing too much swinging. So again, work the negative face. Make sure it's the muscle that's taking the weight down and not gravity. And then you can always, like if you want to do a burnout again, work the top. Don't go all the way down and let it rest. Just work the top, pump. Pump it, pump it, pump it. Ooh. And then, as you can see, you'll get a real nice pump in your rear delt. It's popping now. Favorite exercise for tricep are the extensions. There's a good pull in the cable, so it really works your tricep both ways. And I like to go a little unconventional. I like to work a lot of single arm. I like to work a lot of, you know, the exercises with the handle instead of the bar, because again, you've got more freedom of motion and you can easily also put more variety into your width, even in the same set without having to change the handle. You can again do a superset. So you can start wide like this, where you can go all the way back. Like say if you had a bar, you wouldn't be able to take it all the way back because your legs would be stopping the bar. So with your single hand, you can really come all the way back, almost like if you were doing a kick. You know, you're just further up with your upper body, but you come all the way back and flex that rear head. And then if you want to make it a superset, hit the tries a little bit differently, you can do like a more narrow one. You can even like make a twist. So if you kind of twist it out like this, can you guess where you're hitting the try here? You're hitting the outside, that the long head here. Because I'm twisting and I'm squeezing that. When I'm coming more back here, it's more like the rear head. So you can in one set hit multiple heads. So the next exercise here is an overhand exercise. So when I choose my tricep exercises, it's often like, I'll be like, something like the extension where you're moving downwards, then something that is overhead, and then something that's maybe like in a different angle. Say I'm pushing like more like out, like the second tricep exercise where it was like more like making a twist, or I was pushing more in front of the body instead of like behind the body. So I try to really think about the angles, that every angle is different. So this one is an overhead tricep extension, and what I like about this one is that it's very isolated, because when you're on a bench, you can't cheat. So you can't like use your body to kind of move the weight. So this one is very isolated, and again, get a good stretch, get a good squeeze at the top. Don't just dump it down, you know. Let the muscle take the weight down. Keep and change the speed also, like Sometimes I'm maybe like 1, 2, 3, 4 down, one up. 1, 2, 3, 4, one up. Sometimes I go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Or the opposite, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the hardest one. When you go like really slow on the positive, ooh, that's a burn. And then again, if you want to do a burnout, you can do that. You can also do like the exercise before. You can do a wider grip. Start with that. Or like shoulder width. And then you can pull them together and do like a super narrow grip in the same set to hit it a little bit differently. So there's a lot of choices. Be creative.
Down, down, into the light now. To the light, lost in the sound.